ever, ever. Do you wanna look at me forever, ever, ever?
I promise I'm gonna love you till my dying day. Wake up, you facing my chest, your favorite hiding place. The roof is gone as we're driving out the bright.
Ready?
Mm-hmm. What's up, guys? Welcome to vlog number 3. I'm gonna make a breakfast sandwich really quick. I'm gonna show you how to do it. So first, I got one whole egg, and then I'm gonna add just one serving of egg whites. Let's see, it's 46 grams. Put it here. Oh! It's okay, extra protein. A little bit of Pam spray. We're gonna add 2 ounces of ham, and this is just normally I have deli ham, but today I don't. So just gonna add, it's 1.4. You can't heat it up. And normally, I already know I don't have cheese, like the cheese that I like to use in these sandwiches. I do have some mozzarella. Just a little bit. Literally like half a serving. I know what half a serving is because I use cheese every day. Best English muffins in the world. In the whole world. And I've served high and low. And I can't get it out of the bag. Butter strip. Just a little dab won't hurt you. It's not gonna kill you. It's not gonna kill you. This is not sitting flat. Let me give a review on this smack. We got this as a gift. Shout out Debbie Vollmers. But there's nothing special about it. And it's like a way too expensive toaster. It's like, Alex, how much was the toaster? Like, $150?
Yeah.
$150 for this toaster. It looks pretty, but I can now say it's not worth it. I thought it was gonna like have some like really awesome toasting abilities or settings, and look at this. It's like bagel or like something frozen. Sick. This. Watch it, just look at it. Honestly, I like mustard on mine. Look at the size. Like, this is a pretty decent sized sandwich. It's really hot and it's burning my hands right now. But I'm gonna put the calories on the screen. I eat this like at least 3 times a week. It's super easy, fast, and really good macros and keeps me full for a while. So let me see the first bite. I'm gonna burn my mouth. But doesn't have my favorite cheese on it. I already have to go to the grocery store, so you guys are gonna come with me. Welcome to Publix, the holy grail of grocery stores for us Floridian. Come on. Stay incognito, because I already know we're gonna get such weird looks. When grocery shopping, I like to start on like the produce, fruits, veggies, potatoes aisle. I will totally get to the processed foods, but for the most part, I like to fill up my cart with really nice, healthy, wholesome foods.
A few moments later.
What if nobody is in the shop with me? Because that's normally what it is like people who don't want to be filmed, but as long as it's just me and item, it's not a big deal. Can't do it, probably not. Walmart? So, fork in the road. Do we listen to the guy who's about to look at me? Or do we go to Walmart? Okay, it didn't work. My knowing the owner, manager here, didn't work, so we're gonna have to take everything in the house and go over it then. Okay, the camera. You ready to win? Went up to $1 million. I'm about to be a millionaire on camera right now. Oh, this dust is gonna get in my car. 29, 4, 17. This is a week. First off, this is a week grocery haul. Like, it's not even like an impressive one trip or die trying. But for those that don't know, you can't carry all your groceries in with one trip. You're a week loser. Just kidding. But so let's do it with one hand. Look at that. Look at that, baby. By the way, I took this light down. I convinced Alex that I can totally replace this myself because I'm an electrician now. So I have to replace that today. And hopefully I don't get electrocuted. So, ideally, we obviously wanted to get the whole video in the grocery store to show you where things are and stuff, but we got caught, which I didn't know that was a thing. Like, I knew, but I didn't know. But confirmed, you can't shoot video in a grocery store. So, we followed the rules. All right, I'm breaking the rules right now, but I feel like this is important to say. I already made reference to it, but they're kind of hard to find because they're in the cold section. These are the best English muffins that you'll ever get in your life, and they last the longest. This lasts until March 26th. Anyways, best option now is to just go over everything I grabbed at the grocery store. This was like a medium haul for me. A lot of times, like, it's a really big haul if I need like frozen stuff. I didn't need any meat. Normally I get like chicken or like deli meat. I didn't need that this time. So I'm gonna go over what I did get. As far as bread, said it before, said it 8 times, best English muffins in the world. We got this. I have Sara Lee Honey Wheat. I just really like this bread. I'm not really particular on bread. I don't love the sprouted healthy bread that people say to get. I just don't enjoy it. Lavash bread is what I make my flatbreads with. If you bought my ebook, you know. What else? Eggs. I needed a few more eggs. I didn't need a whole carton because I already have some. So we got some brown eggs. Some salad stuff. I like having salad stuff on hand just if I need some volume and I'm starving. Stuff for salads. I got tomatoes. I like the really colorful ones. Peppers and onions. You can get these whole. I just decided to get them sliced because I'm lazy sometimes when I get home. Other veggies include frozen broccoli. You can totally get fresh broccoli. I just eat broccoli a lot, so I like to keep it frozen so it lasts longer, obviously. Green beans, these are really good, just sauteed with like garlic, salt, and pepper. Cheese, this cheese, I don't know if you can find it anywhere but Florida, to be honest, because it's from Land O'Lakes, which is right up the road. But this is the best American cheese I've ever had in my life. I do use cheese a lot, probably more than most people. Like, some people are like, cut out dairy, it's so bad for you, it's gonna break out your face. But I eat cheese a lot, I enjoy cheese. It literally brings me quality of life, so I eat the cheese. And honestly, like, people make it like the devil. I'm going on like a rant about cheese right now. People make it the devil, but to be honest, like, the macros on it are not bad. Like, a lot of my fats I get from cheeses. Like, one slice of this is 7 grams of fat, 4 grams of protein, and 1 gram of carbs. So, puts on breakfast sandwiches or just sandwiches in general. Eggs, really good. Fruit, got 2 cartons of strawberries. It's strawberry season in Florida, so these are really good. And then 2 cartons of raspberries, and these are really good. I've been on a raspberry kick lately. Got Kodiak cakes. I make these in the morning when I want something sweet. Macros on these. If you've never had Kodiak cakes, I feel like everybody's had Kodiak cakes in the fitness world. But if you haven't and you're watching this video, you should definitely give it a shot. It's a pretty good amount of pancakes for about 200 calories, 14 grams of protein, 30 grams of carbs, 2 grams of fat. Really good. Also got some egg whites. As you saw earlier, I usually mix like one whole egg and then like egg whites in there because egg whites by themselves, I don't care who tells you that, oh, to get lean, you have to eat egg whites and they're delicious. I love egg whites. Like, egg whites taste like floppy paper. No, you need substance, okay? Rice, I already have some rice. I really like these minute rice cups just because you throw them in the microwave and they're really, really quick. But I do have like normal rice that I'll make in the rice cooker if I'm cooking for like the whole week, like meal prepping out. Potatoes, these little baby potatoes, I've been on a kick. They cook really, really fast and I really love them. They don't have the macros on it, but when you put them in MyFitnessPal, it pops up and it's pretty good. Like zero fat, majority of carbs. This is just a carb source for me. Random cucumber, because I love cucumbers. Greek yogurt. I also have some more in the fridge. My fridge never goes without these. Literally never goes. I usually have 5 or 6 in there at any point, just because this is the best sweet treat for someone who counts macros and is diet. You don't have to be dieting, but they're really, really good because they're 80 calories, only 9 grams of carbs and 12 grams of protein. I get a lot of protein from Greek yogurt in general. If you've seen my Greek yogurt, I have here too. And if you follow me on Instagram, you will see, you will see that I mix these two together and make like a ranch dip. And you can dip them, you can use like veggies to dip, pop chips to dip. Pop chips are something that is usually in my grocery haul too, but I am like stocked right now. Pop chips look like this. You can get single bags on Amazon too, but these are amazing. Look at the it's 100 calories for this bag, and you dip them in this dip. It's the best snack in the world, at least for like the past few months of my life. Like I eat it at least 4 or 5 times a week, at least. So Greek yogurt's great. I get a ton of my protein from Greek yogurt. It's also a really good source for like vegans, vegetarians. Actually, no, it's, don't vegans, or who doesn't eat milk products?
Vegans.
All right, just for vegetarians then. What else, anything else? Creamer, it's sugar-free. I don't like to use a lot of calories with creamer, but I really like this flavor. And then finally, also if you follow me on Instagram, you know I'm on a kick of these. I didn't get these from the store, I had them in the freezer, but I feel like it's important to show you them because they're God's greatest gift. They're melting. Oh no. Really, really good. Let me read you the macros. 160 calories. Let me show you the size. 160 calories for one of these guys. 3.5 grams of fat, 29 grams of carbs, 4 grams of protein. And at the end of the day, when you're like, man, I'm tired of eating healthy all day, I'm tired of eating things, I don't know, my food tastes really good throughout the day though, but at the end of the day, I like something sweet, and this is like the perfect, hits the spot, I promise you.
Other drawer, oh!
No!
Blueberries.
How did that even happen?
5 second rule.
So, I posted on my story a Q&A, because I really enjoy doing Q&As. I feel like I get to answer some really cool questions and answer... What? I get to answer good questions that you guys have. So I posted one up either yesterday or the day before, and I picked, I think it was like 20 questions just to like... So I put up a Q&A on my Instagram. Okay. So I put up a Q&A on my Instagram story and went through them, picked a bunch that I thought would be really good to answer for you guys on video. So we're gonna get to that in right now. We're doing it now? Yeah, we're gonna do it now.
And we're back.
We don't know how to structure videos. We're just going with the flow. I'll measure it out. Well, people need to know how to measure it. They were splitting it. So I'm gonna do 100 grams because people need to know like how much is in macros. So we're gonna do 100 grams. I don't really measure this out. It's 0 calories. It says 0 calories for 1/4 a tablespoon. That's probably about how much I would put in, but we're gonna guesstimate. Just a little lot. And then actually, so recently, I haven't showed this on Instagram, but I've been putting a little bit of water because it gives it like a little creamier texture. It's not as thick like Greek yogurt, so just a little dab. I know it sounds weird, like when you put water in it, but just look at that. So the water like loosens it up just a little bit. Oh no, they're seasoning in the spoon. Right. Okay, let me try. Right. I get great joy out of making things that people enjoy, or like finding ways. Does it taste just like that did?
It really does.
Yeah, I know. When I crush this, I'm gonna put it on the screen right here. So, for 100 grams of this, which is that much, it's like it's a good amount. 100 grams is 12 grams of protein. There's 12 grams of protein in this, 0 fat, and 3 carb. I could eat that every day of my life too. And it's like so good. Yeah. Yeah. I can stay this way.
No, for sure.
Like what? Ooh. Alright, let's get to it. Whoa, I skipped one. How did you design your gym and how or who do you market to? I designed my gym literally on a piece of paper. I literally had a piece of paper, I had the square footage, I had the layout of the space, and then I just started drawing things places, legitimately. As far as the logo, I had someone help me with the logo design. I knew what I wanted in my head, and I'll pop the logo up right here so you can see what I'm talking about. Yeah, and who do I market to? I market to, this is a weird question because I don't really market. The only marketing I've ever done is on Instagram. We only have like, I think 45 members, which is great. We wanted to cap it at like 60, so we're right at that. The gym was built more so for a fun space. It doesn't make a ton of money. That's not what it was built for. So yeah. Next, what sports did you play in high school? I played volleyball, basketball, and softball. And I was pretty good in all of them, to be honest. Would you ever create your own supplement company? I have been asked this question a lot, and the answer is no. I mean, like, I don't want to ever say definitively no on anything, but right now it's like, it's not my thing. It's not my passion. I'm not like passionate about supplement ingredients or like at least pursuing something like that. I'm with BPN right now, and they are the, if I were to make a supplement company, it would be so close to BPN that it makes no sense for me to create a supplement company. They're everything I need. Good people, great products. So yeah. Did you go to college? If so, what did you study? I did go to college. I studied sport and entertainment management. Really what my major and what I went to school for, or what I thought I wanted to do, was either be an athletic director or work in like some kind of sports venue, or concert venue or something like that. And obviously it didn't work out like that, which is a blessing. But yeah, that's what I went to school for. Do you think you'll get another dog?
Come on, get up here.
I do not think that I will get another dog while I have these two. They're a handful and I love them. But no dogs anytime soon. Do you miss playing softball? Have you found a way to play post-college? I miss the competition that came with playing collegiate softball. I miss like game day. But do I miss 5 a.m.s and practicing for 3 hours a day? No. I have not. I might have played like competitively like 20 times postseason, like through like slow pitch or like some random league that I would like join. But I have not played softball in like a minute, which is crazy because it was like a huge part of my life for 4 years. But yeah. What's your advice on the best way to go from being overweight to getting ripped? My best advice would be to just start. That's a lot of people like get freaked out by the idea of needing to know everything, like everything down to the little detail before they start. Like, how do I work out? How do I eat? Da, da, da. Like, people, you know what you should be doing. Like, eat less, eat better, get more active. Take those steps and then ask specific questions to get you to your goal. How did you get the scar under your nose? I don't know how you can see. Whoever asked this question has like been zooming on my photos or something. But I got this scar, I think I was like
3 or 4 maybe, and I was in like one of those vans, like a caravan, I think it was like a Dodge Caravan or something, and like the doors that slide open, right? I was leaning up against that, and my oldest brother opened it up while I was leaning against it, and I fell smack on my face and busted this open. And they didn't stitch it, they butterfly stitched it, which is why I have a scar. So, how do you balance work, fitness, self-care, and relationships in this day and age? It's really hard. Like, sometimes I feel like I'm really good at balancing it all. Other times I feel like I'm failing. I think that's pretty normal as a human. But I do my best. I feel like sometimes work is really like just my lifestyle. Like, it's weird because like sometimes plugging products and stuff for me is like, it's work, but it's also like it's what I use, it's what I do. Like, it's just how I am. It's not like I go to a 9-to-5 and I'm there all day. I don't talk to anybody. Like, my life's pretty like fluid. So I feel like I got pretty good balance. Yeah. You coming to the Arnold in Columbus? I am not. I will be out of the country in the Dominican Republic with a bunch of my friends and family celebrating my 30th birthday. My 30th birthday. Yeah. How do we know what our macros are supposed to be? I get this question more often than most questions because I refer to macros a lot. There are a lot of free online calculators. Some are reliable, some are not. I would say, and this is, sounds like such a plug, but the best way to know what your macros are supposed to be, or at least get on like a, you could totally do it by yourself, okay? You can totally, just like how you can learn to play the guitar by yourself, right? You could do YouTube, you can figure it out and just self-taught, right? Or you could get a coach who has been doing it for a while and is able to kind of like look at you, see how your body reacts, and put you on a certain macro, like, budget, and then adjust you from there. It's completely up to you. You can use the free calculators, you can use a coach. Yeah. When you decided to start a business, how did you go about learning what to do? There's this amazing program, called Google. It's amazing. It's incredible. It's wild what you can do on the internet. I learned a lot from just researching myself. And I can honestly say, not that you asking me or asking other entrepreneurs or business owners, how'd you do it, is wrong, but like, to me, like, I never asked anybody, like, how'd you do that? Like, give me the blueprint of how you made your business successful, because how I made my business successful is not always gonna be how your business is gonna be successful. I learned through research and trial and error, and more error, and more trial, and more trial, and more error. Just start, man. Just do it. Google, see what you have to do. Even if you don't feel like you're completely ready to do it, just do it if it really is a passion, if you really do want to start a business. So. When times are rough, how do you stay focused and keep a positive attitude? I don't, man, like, at the end of the day, like, we're all alive. We're all, if you're watching this right now, we're all alive. That's a gift in itself. I have the blessing of health. Like, I'm healthy. I hope you are too. Like, I don't know. There's so many, what I tell a lot of the girls I coach is that when you're really just feeling down in the dumps, like, just start counting your blessings. And I know that sounds super cliche, but it's so true. Like, if I'm like, man, like, this happened to me today, or, you know, I'm having a bad week, like, as soon as you don't have to write them down. It does help to write them down. But as soon as I start reflecting on what is positive going on in my life, it can just snap me back to that like positive mindset. So I encourage you to try that at least. After having the Apple credit card for a few months, how would you compare it to other cards? This card I got solely because it was new. I didn't know anybody that had it and it looked really fun. It's made out of like titanium or something. It's really cool. But at the end of the day, there's nothing super special about it other than it looks really cool. Okay. Cause this is a cool looking credit card. I thought it would be awesome to have, but the perks don't really outweigh any of my other credit cards. My favorite credit card is the Chase credit cards. Like, Chase Freedom is who I have for my personal one. So I would recommend Chase Freedom card over this card any day. Will you be willing to do a video tour of the inside of your new casa? It looks dope. I might. We have some stuff like everywhere, all over the place right now. Alex would kill me if I did it right now. But I think in the future it'd be a cool video to just like see like all the stuff I have in here, furniture and stuff. And I say that because I really enjoy home tours of other people. I'm like, oh, what do they have in their house? Where did they get that? Yada, yada. So yeah, if that would be helpful, we might do that in the future. Do you keep a budget for personal and work, and are they separate? This could be taken two different ways, like time or money. So I'll answer money question first. Do you keep a budget for personal and work? Are they separate? Of course they're separate. My personal finances are completely separate from the business finances. And as far as time, I don't really have a timed budget for how much I work to how much I have for like personal time. A lot of it like really just intertwines. I do try to shut down a lot of times. Like if I'm working, I'll be like, okay, at this time I need to like shut it off. But that shut off valve for me is like most of the time non-existent. So yeah, but I try to keep it separate. Is there such thing as being in too much of a caloric deficit? Absolutely. Don't do it. I know it's like it really appealing to be like, oh, I'm just gonna cut my calories in half, I'm gonna lose all this weight. No, what you're gonna do, you're gonna lose weight for sure, but you're gonna ruin your metabolic efficiency doing that. So don't. Last question. Would you ever consider moving out of Florida? For sure. I grew up in South Carolina, moved to Florida about 6 years ago now. I'm not a city girl. I don't live in the city girl, a city. I don't live in the city right now. I live on the right, like outskirts of it. But I would love to have like land, like four wheelers, like big backyard, big front yard. Like, yeah, I could totally see myself moving out of Florida. Not anytime soon. I just bought a house here, but like 5-10 year plan. Yeah. I'm not saying that I would for sure, but I'm not saying that I would not. So yeah, I'm gonna wrap up this Q&A right now. I hope you enjoyed the entire video. As always, comment, like, subscribe, let us know what you wanna see. I just wanna be of value to you guys and help you guys out as much as I can. Otherwise, this YouTube journey is in vain because I'm not doing it for me, I'm doing it to help you guys out. So let me know and we'll see you in the next one.